The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again. Hello everyone, how are you today? I am Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. And today we are going to talk about insomnia. Why can't you fall asleep? Why do you have problems sleeping? Right. So insomnia is trouble falling asleep, and staying asleep is also a problem. If you cannot stay asleep throughout the night, still you are insomniac. Or sometimes if you wake very early in the morning, that is also included in insomnia. Right. So that is and any of these episodes of insomnia can come and go or can also be continuous for a long time. So the quality of sleep is the most important, as far as it does not matter how long, how much you have slept. It depends upon how much of quality of sleep you get, right? So what causes insomnia? See, sleep habits, as we have learned in your childhood, can actually affect your sleeping behaviors in adulthood also. Poor sleep or bad lifestyle can cause insomnia, and it can include, like, if you go to bed at a different time every day, if you have a habit of daytime napping, if you have poor sleeping environment, such as too much light, too much noise, right? If you spend too much time in the bed while you are awake, yes, that also causes insomnia. Or if you have been working in the evenings or night shifts, that can cause insomnia. Not getting enough exercise will cause insomnia. And using the television, computer, or even a mobile on bed, right, when you are on bed, can cause insomnia. And even medicines, there are some or many medicines like addictions like alcohol or smoking, right, caffeine, too much caffeine throughout the day, right, or drinking caffeine late in the day after evening can cause insomnia. Or certain types of sleep medicines, if you are used to them, then without them you will be again insomnia. Or even some cold medicines or diet pills can cause insomnia, or other, even some herbs or supplements can cause insomnia. Then there are some other mental or even social health issues like bipolar disorders, which can cause insomnia. Sadness or depression can lead to insomnia. Stress, anxiety can also lead to short-term insomnias, but it's mostly not long-term. Right, it depends upon how long your stress or anxiety lasts. Right, then certain health problems like pregnancy will cause problems in sleeping, or physical pain or discomfort if you have a fracture or something, right, that can lead to insomnia. Waking up in the night for using washroom, again very common in men with enlarged prostate or women with UTI, right. Then sleep apnea, very obese people will have this problem of sleep apnea. We have a video on sleep apnea and snoring. Don't forget to watch that as well. Right. And with age also, there is a problem with sleep, change in the sleep patterns. Right. Many people that are aging, right, they that causes them to be insomniac. It becomes progressively difficult to sleep for a long time or even fall asleep. Right. They often wake up more often, right, they sleep for very little time. Apart from all these reasons, right, there can be many other reasons which depends upon your lifestyle. If there is a problem in your lifestyle, that might cause insomnia. Symptoms, number one symptom is obviously you cannot sleep. You have trouble falling asleep on most of the times, most nights, right? It doesn't mean that if you slept for one night, you are okay, no. If most of the times you have difficulty in sleeping, then you have insomnia. If you feel tired during the day, or if you fall asleep during the day, that's a symptom. not feeling refreshed when you wake up, or waking up several times during sleep is also a symptom, right? Sometimes people who have insomnia are consumed by the thought of getting enough sleep, right? They just want to sleep. But in that notion, the more they try to sleep, the more frustrated and upset they get, and it becomes more and more difficult to sleep, right? It gets harder for them. So this lack of a restful sleep can actually make you more tired, more unfocused, restless, right? It becomes difficult for you to do your daily activities. Then you might actually put yourself at risk for accidents, auto accidents, right? So like if you're driving and you're feeling sleepy, then in that case, the accidents can happen. If you feel that is happening, just pull over and take a break. That's the best thing you can do. Take a break. 10 minutes, 15 minutes of nap is also okay to take that break, right? So how do we actually diagnose insomnia? See, when you go to a doctor, physical examination is done, your current medications, drugs use, your medical history, your whole scenario is assessed. And actually, this is the only method where we diagnose. There are no certain tests for insomnia. There is no test for insomnia. We diagnose it on your history, right? Treatment. See, not getting 8 hours of sleep every night does not mean that your health is at risk, right? Different people have different sleep needs, and some people do very good in only 6 hours of sleep a night. Others will only do well if they get 10 to 11 hours of sleep. So that varies upon your lifestyle, upon a lot of factors, right? And treatment is basically done by reviewing your health problems, your drugs history, and then trying to find out the cause of insomnia, right? Like, or trying to find out what is worsening your insomnia, right? Like, for example, if enlarged prostate gland is causing you to wake up in the morning, in the night, then that needs to be treated. Or if there is a pain or discomfort from any kind of, muscular or joint or skeletal pain, nerve disorder, that needs to be taken care of. So you need to think about even your lifestyle and sleep environment, which might be affecting your sleep. So sleep hygiene, this is called sleep hygiene, which you need to maintain, right? And you need to change your sleep habits, which can actually solve your problem. Some people may need medicines, and with the medicines, they will actually get the sleep which they need. But medicines needs to be taken for a very short period of time, right? But if you take it from the wrong run, then you have to make changes in your lifestyle and sleep habit, and in so that you can get off these medicines as soon as possible. So most of these over-the-counter sleeping pills, they contain antihistamines, right? So over-the-counter, that means you can get it by yourself, they will have antihistamines, and these medicines are those medicines which are commonly used for allergies. And your body very quickly becomes used to them. So you cannot use them for a long time. Then there are medicines which are sleep medicines, which are hypnotics or sedatives, which can be only prescribed by a doctor to help you and reduce the time it takes for you to fall asleep, right? This, most of the time, this can actually be addictive, habit forming, right? So you have to understand and use them very carefully. And sometimes medicines can be used just to treat your anxiety, or say you have depression, right? And that will help you go to sleep, right? So these are the types of medicines, and different methods of therapies are there. Even psychotherapy, talk therapy can help you actually gain control over your anxiety, or even if you have depression, all right? So most people, good news is that most people are able to sleep by if they practice good sleep hygiene, right? And all you need to do is look into your life, and we will make a sleep hygiene video also. So don't forget to subscribe the channel and follow this series. And you can just type the topic and write Dr. Education with it on YouTube, and you'll see the video, right? And sleep hygiene video will come soon. Don't worry. So I hope this video was helpful, and we'll make more videos on similar topic. Don't forget to write down whatever topic you want in the comment section below. Give a big thumbs up and share this information. And knowledge is prevention. Sharing is caring. So I'll see you tomorrow. Stay connected. Stay healthy.